What is the problem with Medicare supplement sales right now? It's not what you might think, and I don't know what the way around it is. This video is sponsored by none other than Lead Heroes, you guys. Lead Heroes has got you covered when it comes to telemarketed leads and virtual staffing. On the lead side, whether it be Medicare supplement leads, final expense leads, turning 65 leads, they just got something for everybody. They can also actually have you plug in with one of their virtual staff members on the staffing side to where you can pay by the hour for one of their trained and very well vetted staff members to help you out in your business in a virtual assistant format. Just because you watch this video, they're going to give you 10% off any order you make on their website. Link to the site can be found down in the description, so go ahead and check them out. I'd like to preface my comments in this video by pointing out that this is just an observation of mine. I do not know anything that could possibly talk about what the future is going to hold, but I just want to talk about what I've noticed in the last 2 to 3 years, particularly in the last 12 to 18 months more than anything else, and that is the biggest problem with Medicare supplement sales. I get it. The people that are firm on Medicare supplement, they believe that Medicare supplement is the better product. And here's the kicker with this. So do I. I would rather be on a Medicare supplement than a Medicare Advantage plan probably if I was turning 65, if I had to get on Medicare tomorrow. Here's the issue that nobody seems to be discussing. And I was inspired to actually make this video and have this conversation with you because of a conversation that I had in the Facebook group, Six Figure Medicare Agent, that's closing in on 4,000 Medicare agents, Medicare professionals from all over the country of all walks of life, people from newly licensed agents to people that run FMOs, call centers, and have sold their businesses for 8-9 figures. You got it in there when it comes to diversity, okay? And if you'd like to jump into the Facebook group, links in the description of this video, so go check that out. A little quick plug for the Facebook group. But this is the problem with Medicare supplement that nobody is talking about. It's not the Medicare supplement that's the problem. It's not even the rate increases that are the problem for beneficiaries. It's the Part D guys. In so many markets, and of course this is gonna vary market by market, and it might not be a blanket statement all over the country in every single market, but in so many markets, what my office and my organization is seeing is when you're working with somebody that's taking some tier three, some tier four, some real expensive drug costs. I actually just met with a gentleman a couple weeks ago that was taking about 15 to 20 medications, several of them very, very expensive brand name medications. And when you look at the plans that are available on the Part D side, you're typically looking at anywhere between $6, maybe $7 if you're looking at the cheapest plans, to maybe 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, maybe 35, 40. And in that price range, what you're typically getting is a $480 deductible, if not 400 or something like that, right? It's a very significant deductible. And you factor in the premium, right? On a lot of markets, what I have seen is to get a deductible that is either non-existent or maybe a much, much lower deductible, like per se $100, you're probably looking at $60, $70, $80 a month in the PDP plan's premium. And when you factor in all of these factors, right, and you'll compare these significant drug costs, sometimes, not always, not a blanket statement, but sometimes what you're seeing is the Medicare Advantage plans that include the PDP coverage, that include the Part D coverage, are ending up being sometimes significantly lower in the clients and the beneficiaries' estimated drug costs over the course of the year. This individual that I was talking to was looking at about $4,000 for the remainder of the year in his estimated drug costs on the very best PDP in the market. That's the best case scenario. Anything else was worse than that. It was only downhill from there the more we looked when it comes to the PDPs. You look at the best Medicare Advantage plan in the market, it was under $2,000. It was about $1,800. You wouldn't believe how many people in the last year or so that I've seen come into my office wanting a Medicare supplement, having their mind made up that they want a Medicare supplement, they want a Plan G, they want a Plan N, but then they'll look at the prescription drug costs, right? If they take significant costs of prescriptions, I think if somebody's taking some real inexpensive, cheap generics, it's gonna be covered very well either side, and that's not gonna be that big of a deal. But sometimes if people have some health problems and they already know that they want a Medicare supplement, sometimes those drug costs follow, right? You know that that's probably the next thing out of their mouth. And if we're in a situation now that the drug costs are going to be significantly higher on PDPs versus Medicare Advantage. Now, not everywhere, not a blanket statement, but if we see more of the same and we see funding going into Medicare Advantage to strengthen the PDP formularies and to strengthen the plans to where they don't have deductibles, or if they do have a deductible, it's much lower. Not to say that this is every plan. Again, I'm seeing it in a lot of places, but not everywhere. But I didn't see this 4 or 5 years ago. And so the problem with Medicare supplements for your clients is if they take any significant amount of costs in many areas, and this is kind of what we're looking at, their prescription costs might end up being significantly higher going with a Med Sup because of the PDP than it would with an MA in a lot of places and a lot of scenarios, right? So this is something to keep an eye on. This gentleman that I was talking about that with the best case scenario with the PDP was $4,000 a year in drug costs for the remainder of the year. Now granted, remember that's 6 months. And it was about $1,800 on the best Medicare Advantage plan in the market. He came in wanting a Med Sup. I came in with the expectation to write him on a Med Sup. But he left with a Medicare Advantage once we looked at that. Because when I saw those drug costs, I said, let's just look for kicks and giggles at what it would be on the Medicare Advantage side. And when I showed him that, $0 premium, don't have to pay the Med Sup premium, don't have to pay the PDP premium, plus you're saving $2,200 a year in drug costs. It's hard to argue against that, everybody. He ended up leaving the office with a Medicare Advantage plan. Not what I intended to do, and it wasn't like I was trying to push him into that, but the value proposition was there. So I see the challenge, at least right now, and hopefully it gets corrected, but I don't know if it will, with the Medicare supplement market is the drug coverage and the PDPs. Nothing to do with the Medicare supplements themselves, but the PDPs can be tricky, and oh, can they be challenging, especially in markets that you're seeing. The Medicare Advantage plans have much stronger formularies, much lower deductibles, and no premiums, right? Anyway, guys, I'd love to kind of get your take on this. Do you agree with me? Do you believe I'm right? Do you believe I'm wrong? I'd love to have a conversation about this. Comment down below and let's have a conversation about this, a respectful one at that. Make sure to like this video if you found this video helpful and insightful. It helps the YouTube algorithm help more people find this video just like you who need to hear it. Make sure to subscribe if you're not subscribed already. Hit the notification bell so you're notified when we upload. And until next time, guys, thanks so much for watching. Here's to your success and your abundance. Thanks, guys.